Alright, so this video is going to be a little longer than the others. I apologize in advance, but it is really important that we get these settings done. We'll be configuring ENBoost and downloading the ENB helper. So, the first thing we're going to do is head into our Skyrim installation folder, which is C, Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, and Skyrim. We're going to locate the ENB local .ini, which we got when we installed ENB last episode or video. The first thing we're going to change under global is we're going to find the setting that says use patch speed hack without graphics. And we're going to set that to true because ENB is not currently configured in any way, and so none of the graphics settings are actually set up. For those of you with low-end computers, this is going to keep ENB from totally gobbling up all of your memory and still give you the benefits of the speed hack. So down here, the next setting we need to change is reserved memory size in megabytes. So this, I think, starts out set at 64. You're going to want to change it to 128. This is going to help reduce stuttering in Skyrim. If you save this, you play Skyrim, and you still find that you have some stuttering, you can go ahead and increase this by another 128. So the next one would be 256, and so on. And you can continue to increase it until it lessens the stuttering. The next setting we're going to do is video memory size MB, which is going to be the size of your available VRAM and system RAM combined. And it's very easy to find that out if you don't know what it is. You're going to go into your start menu and open up your control panel. This should work for Windows 8 users too. Just open your control panel and we're going to go to Appearance and Personalization. If your control panel does not look like this, you're going to click up where it says View By and make sure it says Category, and you'll get this setting here. We're going to go under Appearance and Personalization, Adjust Screen Resolution, Advanced Settings, and this window here under Adapter, it's going to tell us the total available graphics memory for our computer. This is the memory from our dedicated video card. If you have a dedicated video card, I do, but it's a very small, very old one. And this is the current available shared system memory. So the total number here, 4735, is my available memory for this computer, which means that I can go ahead and tell ENBoost that is the amount of video memory that I have available for it to use. Your setting will be different depending on your computer and your setup. Remember, if you download an ENB preset from the Nexus, you're going to paste in whatever files they tell you. You're also going to have to go in and adjust ENBoost. If you're using an ENB preset, you're going to want to leave the first setting we did, the patch speed hack without graphics, you're going to want to leave that to false, which will allow the speed settings to do, but you're going to have to go down under the memory size and adjust that every time you install a new preset. So make sure that's always set up properly. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to download ENB Helper, which you can get from dev-c.com/Skyrim/ENB Helper. This is not going to be very useful for those of you who don't intend to use an ENB, but for people who are using ENBs, some of the newer ones, or a lot of the newer ones, require ENB Helper in order to function properly, and so downloading it ahead of time is going to save you some trouble. So those other two files, they weren't important. The important file is enbhelper.dll. We're going to open up our Skyrim folder. We're going to find the ENB series folder, which you will have if you followed my instructions in the last video. And you're just going to drag ENB Helper into that. I already had it, so I'll just overwrite and replace it. But now you have it installed properly. So that is everything you need to know for getting ENB set up